Okay, so you know how it is finding good dining chairs, but like without that crazy price tag.
Yeah, it's like trying to find a unicorn.
Exactly. You want something that will last, but won't empty your wallet.
Well, you're definitely not alone, and today we're going to dive deep into that with a furniture sourcing expert. Ready
You.
to unlock those
Oh,
secrets?
absolutely. I need all the help I can get.
We'll cover materials, construction, and even some cool packaging tricks that can save you some cash.
Oh, like what?
Well, did you know there are companies out there using honeycomb paper instead of plastic?
Really?
Yeah, it's less waste, 80 cheaper.
Oh, that's so smart. Okay, I'm hooked. Let's dive in.
All right, so let's start with, what high quality even means.
Yeah, because we all see those luxury labels everywhere.
Right, but what does it actually mean for a dining chair?
Yeah, for real, I always think it just means expensive.
Often it does, but there are ways to tell if it's actual quality or just a fancy price tag.
Okay, so how do we do that?
It's about looking beyond the surface, kind of like if you were evaluating a business, you wouldn't just look at their website.
Right, you'd want to see their track record.
Exactly. So with a chair, we need to look at the structure.
So, not just how it looks.
Right. The frame is key, and solid wood is what you want.
Any specific type of wood?
Hardwoods are the most durable, like oak or walnut, much better than softwoods.
Hmm, good to know.
And the joints are super important too. Look for things like mortise and tenon joints.
Okay, and why those specifically?
They interlock for strength, much more durable.
So the type of joint actually affects how long the chair lasts.
Big time. And then we have the upholstery. You want to go for a high-density foam.
And why high density?
It keeps its shape, doesn't sag, and it's just more comfortable in the long run. Have you heard of the rub count?
Maybe it's about how strong the fabric is.
Yeah, so it's a test that basically rubs the fabric a ton to see when it starts to wear out. The higher the count, the tougher the fabric.
Oh, so a high rub count means fewer reupholstering costs later on.
That's exactly.
Okay, so that's good to keep in mind when we're shopping. But what about when you find a chair that's almost perfect, but like the fabric's not the right color or something?
Ah, the customization dilemma.
Right. It always seems so expensive.
It can be, but there are companies like ASKT who are doing things differently.
What are they doing?
They use kind of a modular design with standardized parts so they can customize without jacking up the price.
Okay, so how does that actually work?
Imagine building a website with templates. You have the base, but can swap out certain elements.
Okay, I see where you're going with this.
That's where ASKT's approach really shines. They source strategically and manufacture efficiently.
Keeping the costs down.
Exactly. Plus, they have some really innovative ways to cut costs even further without sacrificing quality.
Like that honeycomb paper packaging we were talking about?
Yeah, that's one example. Honeycomb paper is biodegradable and strong and lightweight, so they use less of it.
Reducing waste and shipping costs.
Exactly.
That's amazing. So it's better for the planet and better for our wallets.
Pretty much it's a win-win. And it's part of a bigger trend in the industry.
What do you mean?
Sustainability is becoming a core business strategy, not just a nice to have.
I love that. So companies are realizing that being eco-conscious can actually save them money.
Yep. And it goes beyond just the packaging. Durable, eco-friendly materials like bamboo are becoming more popular.
Yeah, bamboo is amazing, super strong, and renewable.
Right. It's often more resistant to moisture and pests than some hardwoods.
So investing in eco-friendly materials is good for the environment and can save you money in the long run.
Exactly.
So how do we find these innovative manufacturers who are leading the charge?
Well, you got to think like a headhunter.
Okay. I like where this is going.
Don't wait for opportunities. You have to go out and find them.
Okay, so how do we apply that headhunter mentality to furniture?
Trade shows are a great place to start.
Oh, like for networking?
Yeah, think of it as speed dating for the furniture world. You get to connect with tons of manufacturers quickly.
So instead of just browsing online, we get to see the products in person.
Right. You can check the quality firsthand and, build those relationships.
It's like reading a restaurant review versus actually tasting the food.
Exactly. You need that real experience.
But what if we can't make it to a trade show?
You can still connect with manufacturers online.
Like how?
Well, think about how recruiters use LinkedIn to find people.
Okay, so we're talking about networking, reaching out to them directly.
Yeah, LinkedIn, industry forums, it's all about building those connections.
It's like doing your due diligence, making sure their values align with yours.
Exactly. And don't forget about the international B2B marketplaces.
Oh, right. Those are like digital trade shows, right?
Exactly. You can find suppliers from all over the world.
Okay, so that opens up a lot of possibilities. But how do you make sure the quality is good when you're dealing with a supplier so far away? It seems a bit risky.
That's where technology comes in clutch. You can do virtual factory tours and video conferencing.
Wait, so we can actually see the factory and everything?
Yeah, it's like having a window into their production process. You can see the materials, ask questions.
And even if we can't be there in person, are there other ways to, like, check the quality?
Definitely. You could ask for samples and certifications, or even get third-party quality control inspections.
Oh, okay. So, like, layering the checks and balances makes sense. It's like having someone you trust on the ground.
Exactly.
Okay. But negotiating prices can be scary, especially when you're new to this.
Yeah. It's a dance. And trust is super important.
So how do we, like, get a good price without feeling taken advantage of?
Well, you have to respect the manufacturer's expertise, just like a recruiter wouldn't lowball a top candidate.
Right, so it's a partnership, not just squeezing every penny out of them.
And remember, price isn't everything. Lead times, payment terms, after-sales service, all that matters.
Okay, yeah, it's about the big picture. But we were talking earlier about sustainability being a key strategy. Are there any companies besides ASKT that are doing interesting things?
Oh, yeah, there's Amy Co. They make these iconic chairs from recycled materials.
Really? What kind of materials?
Aluminum from old Coke cans, plastic from fishing nets, crazy stuff. And their designs are timeless.
That's so cool. So they're turning trash into treasure. But I'm guessing their chairs aren't cheap.
Well, they focus on quality and craftsmanship, so their prices reflect that.
Yeah.
But their chairs are built to last forever. They even have lifetime warranties.
Oh, wow. So it's an investment that pays off over time.
Exactly. And there's another company called Mater. They use a lot of bio-based materials.
Like what?
Sustainably harvested wood, natural fibers. They even have a chair made from agricultural waste.
From what?
Things like rice husks, sugarcane fibers, even coffee grounds.
No way.
Yeah, it's amazing what they can do now.
It's like the ultimate form of recycling. This is so inspiring. I love seeing these innovative approaches.
It's exciting, right?
So we've covered trade shows, online platforms, even virtual tours. Are there other strategies for finding those perfect chairs?
Don't underestimate the power of data and analytics.
Oh, interesting. Tell me more.
There are platforms now that track market trends, prices, even supplier performance.
Oh, wow. So we can actually make data-driven decisions.
Exactly. You can spot trends, predict demand, and even negotiate better prices.
It's like having a crystal ball for furniture.
Pretty much.
But isn't that kind of data usually expensive?
Not anymore. Many platforms have affordable plans for small businesses and even individuals.
So it's accessible to everyone.
Exactly. It's about leveling the playing field.
I love that. But with so many options, it can feel overwhelming.
True. You need a clear roadmap for your sourcing journey.
Okay. Where do we start?
Figure out your needs and goals first.
What style do we want? Durability, budget, all that.
Yep. How many chairs do you need?
Yeah.
What's your timeline? Once you have that clear vision, you can start researching suppliers.
So being strategic and focused is key.
Right. Don't just randomly browse online or go to every trade show.
And remember, relationships take time.
Absolutely. Don't expect to find the perfect supplier overnight.
It's like dating. You might have to go on a few furniture dates.
Uh-huh. I like that. And just like dating, communication is key.
Be upfront about what we want. Ask lots of questions.
Exactly. And don't be afraid to negotiate.
So we're not just passively accepting whatever price they give us.
No way. You're actively involved. What about bulk purchasing?
Is that always a good idea?
Well, it can get you big discounts and simplify logistics, but you have to think about your storage space, cash flow.
And how much we can actually sell.
Right.
Yeah.
It's a balancing act.
So if I'm just furnishing a small apartment, bulk buying might not be the best option.
Probably not. You don't want to overstock.
You mentioned 3D printing earlier. Is that something that could actually affect furniture sourcing soon, or is it still too futuristic?
It's going from niche to mainstream pretty fast. 3D printing could really change the game.
Okay, how so?
First, it allows for crazy design flexibility and customization.
So you can make totally unique pieces.
Yep, shapes and details that would be impossible or super expensive with regular manufacturing.
And what about waste?
With 3D printing, there's minimal waste.
Oh, because it's additive.
Exactly. You only use the material you need.
Which reduces cost and environmental impact. What about materials? Are there limits to what you can use?
The options are growing all the time. Recycled plastics, bio-based polymers, wood composites, even metal powders.
Oh, wow. So we're not just talking about little plastic models anymore.
Nope. This is about making real furniture from sustainable materials.
And because you're printing it, could you do it locally?
Exactly. You could potentially print furniture anywhere, which cuts down on transportation costs and lead times.
So a more sustainable, efficient, and faster supply chain, this is pretty mind-blowing.
I know, right?
But are there any challenges or hurdles to overcome?
The technology is still developing, and there are some challenges with scale, cost, and some of the material properties.
But it seems like it has a lot of potential.
Huge potential. Early adopters will have a definite advantage.
So it's something to keep an eye on for sure.
Absolutely.
Okay. Wow. We've covered so much already. From sourcing basics to the future of furniture.
It's a lot to take in.
It is. So maybe it's a good time to recap.
Good idea. Let's go over the key points.
All right. Lay it on me. If our listeners remember just a few things from this deep dive, what should they be?
Well, first, do your research.
Don't just settle.
Exactly. Don't just go for the first chair you see or the cheapest option.
Think about the materials, how it's made, what the company stands for.
Right. Like buying a piece of art, you want to know its story.
It's about appreciating the craftsmanship.
Exactly. And research applies to the sourcing process, too.
Explore all the options.
Yes. Trade shows, online platforms, talk to experts. The more you know, the better choices you'll make.
Knowledge is power.
Absolutely.
But even with all the research in the world, things can still go wrong, right? Especially when you're sourcing internationally.
Oh, yeah.
What are some common problems people run into?
International trade can be tricky. Lots of regulations, customs procedures, even cultural differences to navigate.
It sounds like a minefield.
It can be.
So it's not just picking a fabric.
No, you have to understand. Import duties, shipping logistics, maybe even to learn a few phrases in another language.
Oh gosh, that sounds daunting.
It can be. But luckily, there are resources to help.
Like what?
Trade organizations, government agencies, there are even consulting firms that specialize in this.
So they can walk us through it?
Yes. Help you understand the rules, find reliable shippers, even negotiate contracts.
So they're like our guides through the wilderness.
Exactly. And don't forget networking. Talk to other businesses who have experience with international sourcing.
Tap into that collective knowledge.
Right. And even with all the right help, things can still pop up.
Like what?
Shipments can be delayed, products can get damaged, communication can break down.
We need a backup plan.
Always.
Yeah.
And clear contracts are super important.
Don't just rely on a handshake.
No, put everything in writing, payment terms, delivery timelines, quality control, how to handle disputes.
Okay, so like a prenup for your furniture.
Exactly. And consider insurance, too.
To protect us.
Yeah. It can cover you if anything unexpected happens.
Yeah.
Damage during shipping, or even if the supplier goes bankrupt.
Oh, that's good to know. Insurance can be a lifesaver. But even with all the challenges, there has to be something really rewarding about sourcing from other countries.
Oh, absolutely. For me, it's the thrill of the hunt, finding those hidden gems.
Those unique designs you wouldn't find anywhere else.
Exactly. It's like being an explorer.
It's like a culinary adventure, trying new foods and experiencing different cultures through their cuisine.
That's a great analogy.
And it feels good knowing you're supporting artisans and craftspeople all over the world.
Absolutely.
It's about more than just buying a chair. It's about those connections with people and cultures.
It's about creating spaces with meaning, spaces that reflect you and your values.
I love that. You've really shown me how furniture sourcing is so much more than just buying stuff. It's about passion and creativity and appreciating the art of making things.
And that passion can be contagious.
Okay, so we've talked about a lot in this deep dive. The details, the challenges, the excitement of sourcing furniture.
It's been quite a journey.
It really has, and we've given our listeners a lot to think about.
And hopefully the tools to start their own furniture adventures.
So to wrap things up, what's one piece of advice you wish you'd known when you started out?
Don't be afraid to ask for help.
Oh, good one.
There are so many resources out there, experts, organizations, platforms.
Don't try to do it alone.
Exactly. Collaborate. Get guidance. Build those relationships.
That will make the journey smoother.
And a lot more fun.
That's great advice. And on that note, I think it's time to wrap up this deep dive.
It's been a pleasure.
We've gone from the basics to the future, explored the challenges and the rewards.
We've covered a lot of ground.
We have. And now our listeners are ready to go find those perfect chairs.
Go forth and source.
With confidence and curiosity.
And an appreciation for the craft.
We'll catch you on the next deep dive. Okay, I'm all about this headhunter strategy. You got to tell me more.
Well, like I said, trade shows are a great starting point.
So it's all about those face-to-face connections.
Exactly. You can see the products up close, assess the quality, you know, really connect with potential suppliers.
Makes sense. It's totally different from browsing online. You get that real-life feel.
Exactly. You get that hands-on experience.
But what if, you know, you can't actually make it to a trade show?
No worries. You can still network with manufacturers online.
Okay, how do you even start with that?
Think about how recruiters use LinkedIn.
Okay, yeah.
You can do the same thing for furniture sourcing.
So we're talking about reaching out, connecting, building a network.
Exactly. LinkedIn, industry forums, all great places to start.
It's like doing your homework, you know, vetting them, making sure they're a good fit.
Absolutely. And don't forget about international B2B marketplaces.
Oh, right. Those are like, what, digital trade shows?
Yeah, exactly. You can find suppliers all over the world.
Okay, so the possibilities are endless. But how do you, you know, ensure the quality is there when you're dealing with a supplier that's miles away?
Well, there's where technology really helps. You can use video conferencing, even do virtual factory tours.
Wait, so you can actually see the factory?
Pretty much. You can get a glimpse into their production process, check out the materials, ask questions.
That's incredible. Technology is amazing.
Yeah.
But even if you can't physically be there, are there ways to ensure the quality?
Definitely. You can always ask for samples, request certifications, or even have a third-party inspector check things out.
Oh, okay. So it's about adding layers of, what, checks and balances.
Exactly. To make sure everything is up to par.
Okay, that makes me feel better. But let's be honest. Negotiating prices can be kind of scary, especially when you're new to this.
It's true. Negotiation is an art, and building that trust is crucial.
So how do we, you know, get a good price without feeling like we're being taken advantage of?
Well, just like a good recruiter wouldn't lowball a talented candidate, you need to respect the manufacturer's expertise.
Right. So it's more of a collaborative approach, not just trying to squeeze them for every penny.
Exactly. And remember, price isn't the only thing that matters. Lead times, payment terms, after-sales service, all of that plays a role.
Right. It's about looking at the whole picture. Speaking of which, we were talking earlier about sustainability being a core business strategy. Are there any companies besides ASKT that are doing cool things in this space?
Absolutely. There's this company called Imago. They make these incredible chairs out of recycled materials.
Oh, wow. Like what?
Aluminum from old Coca-Cola cans, plastic from fishing nets, all sorts of things.
No way. That's amazing. So they're literally turning trash into treasure.
Yep. And their designs are timeless. They'll last for years.
That's so cool. But I'm guessing these chairs don't come cheap?
Well, they prioritize quality and craftsmanship, so their prices reflect that. But these chairs are built to last. They often come with lifetime warranties.
Oh, wow. So they really are an investment.
They are. And there's another company, Mader. They use a lot of bio-based materials.
Oh, like what kind?
Sustainably harvested wood, natural fibers. They even have a chair made from agricultural waste.
Wait, agricultural waste?
Yeah, things like rice husks, sugarcane fibers, even coffee grounds.
No way. That's incredible. I had no idea you could make furniture out of that.
It's amazing what they're doing these days.
It really is. So we've talked about trade shows, online platforms, virtual tours. Are there any other tools or strategies to help us find those perfect chairs?
Don't forget about data and analytics.
Oh, interesting. How does that play a role?
Well, there are platforms that track market trends, price fluctuations, even supplier performance.
So we can actually use data to make informed decisions about our sourcing.
Exactly. You can spot emerging trends, anticipate demand, even negotiate better prices.
Wow. It's like having a crystal ball for the furniture industry.
You could say that.
But that kind of data usually costs a lot of money, right?
Not necessarily. Many of these platforms have really affordable subscription plans, even for individuals.
So it's accessible to everyone.
Exactly. It's all about leveling the playing field.
I like that. But with so many options, it can feel kind of overwhelming. Where do you even begin?
You need to create a roadmap for your sourcing journey.
Okay, a roadmap. I like that. So where do we start?
Start by defining your needs and goals.
So like, what style do I want? What's my budget? How durable do I need it to be?
Exactly. How many chairs are you looking for? What's your timeline? Once you have that clear vision, you can start researching and filtering potential suppliers.
So it's about being strategic, not just randomly searching online or going to every trade show.
Exactly. And remember, building relationships takes time.
So don't expect to find the perfect supplier overnight.
Right. It's a process.
It's like dating. Sometimes you have to go on a few dates before you find the one.
I love that analogy. And communication is key, just like in any relationship.
So be upfront about your expectations, ask questions, don't be afraid to negotiate.
Absolutely.
Okay, that makes sense. Now, what about bulk purchasing? Is that always the best strategy?
Well, buying in bulk can definitely save you money, and it can streamline logistics. But you need to consider a few things.
Like what?
Well, you need to think about your storage space, your cash flow, and how quickly you can actually sell the chairs.
Right. You don't want to end up with a warehouse full of chairs that you can't move.
Exactly. It's all about finding that sweet spot.
Okay. So maybe bulk purchasing isn't always the right move, especially if you're just furnishing a small apartment.
Probably not.
You mentioned 3D printing earlier. Do you think that's something that could really shake up the furniture world soon, or is that still, like, way off in the future?
I think it's moving from a niche technology to a mainstream production method pretty rapidly. It could definitely revolutionize furniture sourcing.
Okay, I'm intrigued. How so?
Well, first of all, it offers incredible design flexibility and customization.
So we could create truly unique pieces tailored to specific spaces and needs.
Exactly. And since it's an additive manufacturing process, there's very little waste.
Oh, right. Because you're only using the material you need.
Precisely. Which lowers costs and reduces environmental impact.
Makes sense. What about the materials themselves? Are there limits to what can be used for 3D printing furniture?
The range of materials is constantly expanding. We're seeing recycled plastics, bio-based polymers, wood composites, even metal powders.
Wow, that's incredible. So we're not just talking about prototypes anymore. This is about making real high-quality furniture.
Exactly. And 3D printing also has the potential to localize production.
Oh, interesting.
What do you mean? Instead of shipping furniture across the globe, you could potentially print it locally.
Wow, that would save a lot on transportation costs and lead times.
It would. It would make the supply chain more efficient and sustainable.
It's pretty mind-blowing when you think about it. But are there any hurdles to overcome before 3D printing becomes the norm for furniture?
Of course, the technology is still evolving, and there are challenges with scalability, cost, and some limitations with material properties.
But it sounds like it has a lot of potential.
Immense potential. Early adopters will have a real advantage.
So it's something to keep an eye on, for sure.
Definitely.
Okay, so we've covered a lot of ground in this deep dive. Everything from traditional sourcing strategies to these futuristic technologies. It's clear that there are more options than ever for finding the perfect chairs. But with so much information, it's probably time for a recap.
I agree. Let's summarize what we've learned.
Okay, give me the highlights. What are the most important things our listeners should take away from this conversation?
I think the biggest takeaway is, you know, really do your research.
Don't just jump at the first thing you see.
Right. Take the time to understand the materials, the construction, even the company's values.
It's like you said earlier, it's like buying art. You want to know the story behind it.
Exactly. And that research extends to the sourcing process, too.
So exploring different options, like trade shows and online platforms.
Yeah, read industry publications, talk to the experts, you know, really get informed.
So the more we know, the better decisions we can make.
Exactly.
But even when you do all your research and you think you're prepared, things can still go wrong.
Oh, yeah, especially with international sourcing.
What are some of those challenges that people might run into?
Well, one of the biggest is navigating international trade. You know, different countries have different regulations, customs procedures.
It's not as simple as just picking out a fabric you like.
It could be a lot more complicated than that.
So we're talking about understanding import duties and shipping logistics, even maybe learning a little bit of another language.
Yeah, it can be like assembling a piece of furniture with instructions in a foreign language.
Oh gosh, that sounds like a headache.
It can be.
Yeah.
But the good news is there are resources to help you.
Oh, good.
Yeah, you can find trade organizations, government agencies, even consulting firms that specialize in this stuff.
So they can kind of hold our hand through the process.
Exactly. They can help you understand the regulations, connect you with reliable shippers, even negotiate contracts.
So they're like our international trade Sherpas.
Pretty much. And don't forget about networking, too.
Right. Reaching out to people who've done this before.
Exactly. Talk to other businesses, designers, architects. They can give you great advice and maybe even introduce you to some good suppliers.
Okay. So it's all about tapping into that collective knowledge and experience.
Yeah. And even with the best preparation and support, unexpected things can happen.
Like what?
Well, shipments can get delayed. Products can arrive damaged. Sometimes communication breaks down.
So we need to have those backup plans in place.
Always. And having really clear contracts is crucial.
So not just like a verbal agreement or a handshake.
No, definitely get everything in writing.
Okay, so we're talking about payment terms, delivery dates, quality control. even a process for handling disputes.
Yeah, all the important details.
It's like having a prenup for your furniture.
Exactly. And don't forget about insurance.
Insured.
It can protect you financially if something goes wrong. You know, like if the shipment gets damaged or the supplier goes out of business.
Oh, that's a good point. Insurance is definitely something to consider.
Yeah, it's like a safety net for your investment.
But even with the challenges, there must be something really special about sourcing furniture from other countries, right?
Oh, yeah. I think for me, it's that feeling of discovery. You know, finding those hidden gems, those unique designs you wouldn't find anywhere else.
It's like being an explorer, bringing back treasures from a far-off land.
Exactly. And there's a sense of satisfaction that comes from supporting artisans and craftspeople around the world.
It's about more than just buying a chair. It's about connecting with different cultures and traditions.
And at the end of the day, it's about creating spaces that are meaningful, spaces that reflect your personality and your values.
I love that you've really captured the heart of what makes furniture sourcing so special. It's about passion, creativity, and a deep appreciation for the craft.
And I think that passion is contagious.
Before we wrap up, what's one piece of advice you'd give to someone who's just starting out on their furniture sourcing journey?
I'd say don't be afraid to ask for help.
That's great advice.
There's so much information out there and so many people who are willing to share their expertise.
So reach out, collaborate, build those relationships.
Exactly.
Well, that's a perfect note to end on. We've covered so much in this deep dive, from the nitty-gritty details of materials and construction to the future of furniture design and the stories behind each piece.
It's been an amazing journey.
It has, and hopefully our listeners are feeling inspired and empowered to go out and find those perfect chairs.
Absolutely.
So to our listeners, thank you for joining us on this deep dive. We'll see you next time.